Well, Matt Moran is a celebrity chef with a string of hugely successful restaurants, and today he's cooking in our little kitchen with some of the best quality produce you can find in Australia. He's brought a few little mates with him, actually. Good morning, Matt Moran.
Good morning. How are you guys? Actually, not in Australia, in the world.
In the world. There we go. We're
notorious for having some of the best produce in the world. There's no question.
Well, what are we making today, then?
Look, these are Flinders Island lobsters. Now, they're part of the Delicious Produce Awards, the Harvey Norman Produce Awards. Every year, a group of chefs get together, we judge all this incredible produce, and it's just absolutely amazing. I've been involved for about 15 years.
Wow.
And it's, you know, as a chef, you know, we're only as good as the product that we use. And if it wasn't for the producers, if it wasn't for these growers, we would not be where we are. There's no question. So it's a great way of actually, you know, promoting these guys for the hard work that they actually do.
We've got Flinders Island lobster. Oh, so where do we get started? What do we do first?
So all we're doing is we're just doing one of my recipes, which is the lobster, which has just been blanched. And we've got a little bit of a beurre blanc here, which is just basically a little bit of white wine, vinegar. We reduce it down with peppercorns. And then we actually add a little bit of butter to it and some lemon. And we're just basically folding that through. We've got these beautiful little buns with a little bit of watercress seasoning. And it's just like a great little sort of, you know, hot dog, lobster roll that you can have at parties. So I'm just going to keep going
on
this.
See, when it comes to these, what's the secret to removing the flesh from the shells?
Yeah.
Look, it's all about, look, you've got to be, they start like this. And I know size doesn't really matter.
Oh, my gosh. Just the size of these things.
I've actually got a live one here.
Oh, wow.
Look at the size of that.
Will it bite you? Will it...
No, it won't bite you, but he can probably claw you.
Oh.
But
he probably would if he sees you biting him.
So what we always do is do it in a humane way. So we actually put them in the freezer, we let them go to sleep, they pass away, boiling water, pop them in, you blanch them, depends on how big it is. As you can see, this one here is a little bit translucent, so it's not cooked all the way through, and that's exactly how you want it. You know, lobster to me, eating sashimi, is unbelievable. Now, the guy that farms this from Flinders Island, his name's Jack Wheatley. He's a finalist this year. He's been fishing for lobster for 70 years.
Oh, what a character.
Yeah,
Look at him.
He's a real character. And not only that, he gets all his own bait. He makes all his own cages. And the great thing about it is they've kept alive in the water. Mm. So when the plane comes, he actually takes them from the ocean that he's caught already. He pops them straight into the plane. They came straight into Sydney, or come straight into Sydney, Melbourne, or wherever they're going, and they're still alive. So you know that they are super, super fresh.
Mm-hmm.
As you can just see those two there. Oh. Those two are some of the biggest ones I've ever seen. But he's all about sustainable fishing. So he only fishes in the one spot and he won't fish it out. He's got a proper quota.
Wow.
And that's exactly what we want. And this year, we're really focusing on those farmers that, you know, are all about sustainability and also regen and looking after the land. Because, you know, if we don't start looking after the land, we won't have any produce.
Sounds like a silly question, Matty, but in this recipe that we've got up on the screen now, you can swap crayfish for lobster. What's the main difference there?
Oh, look, there's no difference at all.
Okay.
The crayfish is a lobster. It depends on what side of the country you're coming
from. Right,
not side of the country, but what side of the world. But you could use prawns, you could use crab meat, you could use any sort of shellfish whatsoever.
I don't think I've ever tasted lobster in my whole life.
Really?
In my 40 years on this planet, I've never tasted it.
Really?
Should I taste it now?
What a treat to be on a brioche roll as well.
Yeah.
Dig in.
I thought that you would have, you know, that would have been a daily
No, I actually never have.
Bit of drizzy,
so is it like crab?
No, it's not. It's more like a texture of a prawn, I would say.
Mm.
But it's, you know, lobster is always seen as the pinnacle. You know, it's expensive.
That's what
it is really, really
it's
special.
It's actually delicious.
Tristan,
it's actually beautiful. Yeah.
But paddock to plate, it's so important. Though, isn't it?
Yeah, look, it is. And, you know, it's nowadays,
not fishy.
Nowadays, everyone wants to know where their produce comes from.
Mm.
You know, you want to know that it's been bred really well, it's been farmed really well, it's been handled really well. And, you know, once you start seeing those brands and you know that's a fact, that's the ones that you actually keep going back for. That's when you go to restaurants these days. You don't just see beef fillet, you see where it comes from. Yeah. So people recognise, you know, that brand because you know that it's good, sustainable and they're doing the right thing.
That's so important. Is there any more to know about the Harvey Norman, the Produce Awards?
Yeah, look, we've got the finalists now. We've actually just finished judging today. So it'll come out soon, all the winners from, you know, different areas. So you've got the earth, you've got the sea, you've got the paddock, you've got the dairy. And then there's a big producer who wins at the end. And it's quite a big accolade because you have some of the best chefs in the country.
Mm.
You know, we all come in, you know, we all meet and it's one of those dream jobs that, you know, you just love every year. For those 2 days, you know you're going to eat incredibly well. It's always cooked pretty bloody well too, just quietly.
Just like us right now, yeah? That's
the How's your little family farm coming along?
Yeah, look, I've got a farm at Rockley. We produce fat pigs, we've got second cross lambs, and we've got Angus cattle. But I've just recently bought a pub. I've been spending a lot more time at the farm, and I thought, look, if I'm going to spend more time out there, I need something else to do. So I bought the local pub.
You get thirsty.
And I bought a house next to it and a couple of blocks of land, so we're going to put a bakery eventually. We're going to have heaps of accommodation, and we're going to have a bistro and a beer garden and a pub. We've opened it just for the locals, but we've been getting slammed. We're doing like 1,000 people a weekend.
Oh, my gosh, fantastic. That's amazing.
Yeah, so
you got Guinness on tap there, or...?
We've got an old, but not yet. But I'll make sure if I know you're coming, I'll definitely have it.
Yeah, we'll put it on the to-do list. For the full list of national finalists, head to delicious.com.au/produce awards. Matt Moran, it was a pleasure having you come in with food.
Pleasure.
Thank you so much for cooking for us and chatting.